Hi, I'm Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to give you my best tips to get a graphic design internship if you're a student. All right, let's get started. First, you'll want to build a strong portfolio, and this can be, I think 8 is a great number of projects. These can be classwork, personal projects that you just made up, freelance, or even like mock briefs that you found online. You'll want to show variety, so logos, branding, magazine layouts, digital work like social graphics, and other print work. Definitely put your portfolio online. If you're going to an interview, it's okay to do a print portfolio in addition to this digital portfolio, but these days digital is standard. If you have Adobe Creative Cloud, which most of you will, I'm sure, you can use their Adobe portfolio. This is what I use for my own portfolio. You can also use sites like Behance or your personal website, but whichever one you choose, put your work on the first page so it's the first thing that people see when they go to your portfolio. Let's take a look at some portfolios that were made with Adobe Portfolio that I think are really successful. The first one is this portfolio by Julius Cruikshank. And the thing I love about this, and really with all these portfolios, I'm not really talking about the projects themselves, although of course these are very nice. I'm really more talking about the layout. So he's got a really short blurb right here, and then he's got his projects immediately visible with thumbnails and mouse over so you can see what you're going to get if you click. The thumbnails are all pretty different looking, and everything looks very professional. And then of course you can click in and see the project itself. The next one is by Vinay Chana. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right, but this one also is straight into the work. You don't get, you know, an about me or other information here. You get to see the work right off the bat. And then the last one is my portfolio. This one is set up pretty much the same way. I've got all my projects as the first thing you see. I actually think the other two layouts are a little better because it's nice to have some space between them. But anyway, the common theme here is just having your projects be the first thing someone sees when they go to your portfolio. The next tip is to really polish your resume and get your LinkedIn up to date. Your resume should highlight your skills like, you know, Photoshop, Illustrator, Figma, if you know that. Anything that is design related should be on there. As far as experience goes, since you're a student, you probably won't have that much, but if you had a job like at a copy and print center, that counts as experience if you do any kind of graphic design work there. Or if you help in the design lab at your school, that is good experience. You can also include freelance, any projects you do for people, even if they are for free, and volunteer work too. LinkedIn is huge. You definitely want to have a LinkedIn profile and it needs to be up to date. When companies look for interns, they are assuming that you will have a LinkedIn. And if you don't have one, that could look pretty bad. Also, write a cover letter that's easy to customize based on whatever you're applying to. Just keep it really concise, enthusiastic, and say why you want to work there. And of course, why your skills fit the position. When you're getting ready to start your internship search, there are really three paths you can take, and I would do all three if you need to. First is job boards, the obvious Indeed.com, LinkedIn, and Handshake. Now, I've never used Handshake, but I've heard it's pretty great for students. Next is networking. Let everyone you know that you're looking for an internship. A lot of companies have little design firms right inside them. It's called in-house design. So even though your network might not be graphic design related, people might work at a company who hires interns for their design team. Make a post on Facebook or Instagram asking if people know of any internships for design students. And of course you can ask your professors, other people you know in the industry, past employers or mentors. See if they have any leads at all. And then the third way is with direct outreach. So this is where you search Google for design firms in your area and then either use their contact us form. That is not the greatest way to do it, but it's easier than trying to find out what their email addresses are at that company. But there are ways to go about doing that. If you can email someone who is in a design role at a company already, that is a great way to get in, especially once they see your great work with your 8 projects in your portfolio. One thing to think about is you need to really think about the timing for internships. So usually people hire for a spring semester. So if you can go a couple of months before that and start looking around at that time, instead of during the spring semester, for example, that is going to be your best way of going about it. So for the fall semester, this is going to be like May through August that you'll be looking for an internship. Or for the spring semester, you'll want to go more October through November. People don't think about hiring in December because all the holidays are going on. A lot of people ask off work, and the last thing that's on anybody's mind is hiring for an internship most of the time. Next, you'll want to prepare for your internship interview. So be ready to discuss your design process, your favorite project in your portfolio, and why you made the choices you made, and other questions like how to handle feedback. Make sure to research the company before you go to the interview so you know what they're all about and kind of their value system. You need to be able to talk about the work they're doing and show genuine interest in it. So why would you even want a graphic design internship? Well, there are a lot of reasons. First, you get real-world experience. You get to learn all about kind of the design process and how it works in a company, following briefs, deadlines, and just the general design workflow. You could also possibly get portfolio-ready work from your internship, which is awesome. You'll also get a lot of on-the-job training and mentorship, hopefully. Now, if you're looking for an internship, this is something that I would make sure that they're offering with the internship, because these two things are really the whole point. You're supposed to learn a ton at an internship. Another cool thing is you might meet a lot of people that will help you get a job later, so networking. And then some internships even turn into full-time positions. So here are some things that are not so great about internships. First, a lot of them are unpaid or low paid. You might also have limited creative control. In a lot of internships, you'll find yourself doing production work, which is actually pretty great too. Those skills can really set you up for an awesome creative career later. Another thing that might be an issue is the time commitment. So you'll obviously still be in school and juggling this internship, plus another job if you need one and the internship isn't paying you. So it can be pretty overwhelming. Another problem might be commuting or working remotely. Working remotely, I'm not sure I would want to do an internship that was completely remote unless they had pretty good training. I think one of the huge benefits of an internship is sitting right by a designer who can show you what to do if you have a problem or you can bounce ideas off of. So I would only take a remote position if it was the only option. Another thing is that internship quality really varies. So you can have a great internship where you learn a ton and it's very creative, or you can have one where you're sort of, you know, the person who does everything that nobody wants to do. Either way, you're going to learn a lot, so I would just suck it up. You don't really know for sure what you're going to get in the interview process. When I was in charge of supervising the interns at our company, I would really try to make sure they got the fun projects because I wanted them to see how fun design can really be. I didn't want to just give them all the crap work. On the other hand, I didn't want to give them something that was too challenging for them. So it's a fine line. So a few final tips. Internships are not like real jobs, and it's totally okay to reach out to companies directly to ask them if they're hiring interns. I actually think it's okay to do this with regular design jobs too, but it doesn't happen, so maybe I'm wrong about that. Also, don't just dismiss unpaid internships as something you absolutely will not do, because a lot of them will give you really great experience. And some are geared to help you, the intern, as opposed to helping the company get further along, because a lot of times the work that interns do has to be redone sometimes, and there's a lot of training involved and a lot of extra work for the person supervising the intern. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you did and you want to see other videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.